Linear algebra lecture 6 on linear span by Dr. P. Ramlu, head department of mathematics, MBS government arts and science college, Mahunagar. Today I am going to discuss about the linear span. So before going to discuss about the linear span, now I am going to discuss some linear combination of vectors. So after defining linear combination vector, I want to define linear span. So up to lecture 5 I have discussed about the vector space and example of vector space and subspace and theorems of subspace we have learned. Now I am going to define linear span. So what is a linear combination of vectors? Before going to discuss about the linear combination linear span, now I am going to define linear combination of vectors. Let V over B a vector space, S is equal to V1, V2 dot as V and subset of V, and A1, A2 dot as An belongs to F, then gamma is equal to A1, V1, A2, A2 dot as plus An, Vn is called linear combination of vectors of S. So what I am doing here, let V over B a vector space, S is equal to V1, V2 dot as Vn is a subset. I want to take scalars from here. This S is subset of V and A1 belong in F. I want to multiply this A1 to AV1, A2 V2, AVN. So I am writing this sum, okay, is called linear combination of vectors of S. Example, right? Show that S is equal to 1, 0, 0, 1, subset of R2 is a linear combination of 1, 1. We have to show that this set S is equal to 1, 0. 0, 1 is a linear combination of 1, 1. I want to show this is right. So, gamma is equal to, I am writing here, AU1 plus BV2. So, this I want to find in AV1, V2. I am taking this. A times of V1, A times of V1 nothing but this, V2 nothing but this. So, my gamma is equal to 1, 1. I am writing gamma is equal to this. Gamma equal to A times of V1, B times of V2. That means 1 comma 1 is equal to, I multiply here A1 comma 0, 0 comma B. If I add this thing A comma B, that means if I compare this element, A equal to 1, B is equal to 1. Therefore, 1 comma 1 equal to 1 dot 1 comma 0 plus 1 comma 0 comma 1, right? So, this is called to, this vector is a linear combination of this vector. That means, so I am taking this element in R2 and A comma B comma, I am taking field F, field in R. So, I am taking this element, gamma is equal to this element. I am writing this element in the linear combination of this element. Therefore, this element is a linear combination of these elements. Let S is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. This subset of R3 is a linear combination of 1, 1. Writing gamma is equal to this, this is V1, V2, V3, so gamma is equal to A1, V1, A2, V2, A3, V3. Let gamma is equal to 1, 1, 1, A1 equal to A1, and V1 nothing but 1, 0, 0, V2 nothing but 0, 1, 0, V3 nothing but 0, 1, 0, right? If I multiply this, what will get here? A1, 0, 0, if I multiply this, 0, A2, 0, if I multiply this, 0, 0, A3. If I adding this, A1, A2, A3, 1, 1 equal to A1, A3. That implies A1 equal to 1, A2 equal to 1, A3 is equal to 1. Which implies 1, 1, 1 equal to 1 to 1, 0, 0 plus 1 dot this. That means this element is a linear combination of, that means I want to find these elements of this. Next, S is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, is a linear combination of 1, 2, 3. If you take that 1, 2, 3, we can easily write that 1 into 0, 0, 2 into 0, 1, 0, 3 into 0, 0, 1. That means if I add in this, we will get this element too. Therefore, this element is a linear combination of this. Example, S is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, subset of R3. Show that S is a linear combination of 9, 11, 13. So, this is formation I am taking in the row operation. So, that means row vector. Here I am taking that column vectors. I am taking that this vector is a linear combination. That means if I write the gamma is equal to A1, V1, gamma equal to this, and A1, V1, A2, V2, that equal to V1 nothing but this, V2 nothing but this, V3 nothing but this. by adding this, what you will get? A100 plus 0820 and 00A3. If adding this, so what we get? A1, A2, A3. So 9, 11, 13 equal to A1, A2, A3. A1 nothing but 9, A2 nothing but 11, A3 nothing but 13. That means 9, 11, 13 is equal to A1 times, sorry, 9 times of 100, 11 times of 010, 13 times of 010. Therefore, this vector is a linear combination of these vectors. Now we can show that S is equal to 1, 2, 2, 3, so set up is a linear combination of 4, 5. I'm taking that gamma is equal to A1, B1. Therefore, I am writing gamma is equal to here 4 comma 5 A1, sorry, you can take that AB here, not A1, B1. V1 nothing but, you can take U1, U2, whatever, nothing, you, I am taking this is U1, this is U2, 1, 2, plus B times of 2, 3. If I multiply this, what will get here? A times 2A plus 2B, 3B. If I add these terms, so A plus 2B, 2A plus B, if I equating this, what will get here? A plus 2b is equal to 4 and 2a plus 3b is equal to 5, which implies I am taking common out or multiply both sides this element 2. What will get here? 2a plus 4 is equal to 8. This equation already we know that 2a plus 3b is equal to 5. If I solve these two equations, so then what will get here? 4b minus 3b, that equal to b. 8 minus 5 is equal to 3, so b is equal to 3. 2a plus 4, 3 is equal to 8, 2a is equal to 8 minus 12. 2a is equal to minus 4a is equal to minus 2, b is equal to 3 and a equal to minus 2. Therefore, 4 comma 5 is written as minus 2 times 1 comma 2 plus 3 times of 2 comma 3. Therefore, this element is a linear combination of this and this. Show that S is equal to 100, 110, 111 subset of R3 is a linear combination of 1, 2, 3. Again, I am writing here gamma is equal to 1, 2, 3 and this element V1, V2, V3 equal to, I am writing here 1, 2, 3 in times of A1 times 100. A2 times of 10, like A2 times of 100 and A3 times of 11. So I'm writing here 1, 2, 3 equal to A1 times of this, A2 times A2, A2 comma 0, A3, A3 comma 0. If I add these things, so I'll get 1, 2, 3 equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3, 0 times of A2 plus A3 plus 0 times A3. That means if I equaling this equation, so A1 plus A2 plus equal to 1. A2 plus A3 equal to 2, A3 equal to 3. If I substitute A3 equal to here, A2 will get A2 equal to minus 1. If I substitute A3 and A2 here, then what will get to A1 equal to minus 1. That means A1 equal to minus 1, A2 is equal to minus 1, A3 is equal to 3. Therefore, 1, 2 is a linear combination of, 1, 2, A3 is a linear combination of this element. So, this and this and this. Therefore, that means this is written as the combination of linear combination. That's why this is a linear combination of this element in R3. Show that S is equal to 1, 1, 2, 2 subset of R2 is not linear combination of 1, comma 2. Just already we have shown that all the linear combination of vectors, but here I am taking that this is not linear combination of vector. So here I am taking that 1, comma 2, gamma is equal to 1, comma 2, this is V1, V2. So gamma is equal to AV1 plus BV2. 1 comma 2 is equal to A times of 1 1 and B times of 2 2, that is 1 comma 2 is equal to A plus 2 B and A plus 2 B. So A plus 2 B is equal to 1, A plus 2 B is equal to 2, that means so A comma B belongs to R such that 1 comma 2 is equal to A1 B1. So that if for what elements it must satisfy, for what values of A comma B, if the we can what values of A comma B these two equations satisfies. I am taking that A plus 2B is equal to 1 and A plus 2B is equal to 2. If I substitute any value here, we are unable to find it. If we substitute any value, these two equations not satisfied. Why? Because left hand side is the same, but right hand side is different. A plus 2B equal to, if I substitute any value, this cannot be satisfies. That means there does not exist A comma B will have to ask us that 1 comma 2 is equal to A times of 1 1 and B that is. That means we have shown that 1 comma 2 is not linear combination of these vectors. So, okay. Maybe some other element may be linear combination of these vectors. Some other element is a linear combination of this vector, but this is not linear combination of this vector. So, right. So, this vector, this subset of R is not linear combination of 1 comma 2. That means why? Because we are unable to find A comma B such that 1 comma 2 equal to this time plus this, right? Show that 1 1 1 2 2 2 3 3 is not linear combination of 1 2 3. Same, I am taking that gamma is equal to a1 v1 v2 a1 v1 a2 v2 a3 v3 1 2 3 is equal to a1 times of 1 1 1 a2 times of 2 2 2 plus a3 times 3 3 3. If by adding substitute value get the 1 2 3 is equal to, we will get this again a1 plus a2 plus a3. That means so a1 plus 2 a2 plus 3 is equal to both left hand side will be same and right hand side 1 2 3. Similar case happened, right? If left hand side is equal same, right? But if I substitute any value, right hand side may not be equal. Why? Because we are unable to find any values in such way, right? Therefore, there does not exist to a1, a2, a3, a1 cross is that 1, 2, 3, a1, 1, 1, a2, 2, 2, 2, plus a3, 3, 3, 3. Therefore, this is equal to 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3. It is not a linear combination of 1, 2, 3. Okay? So, this is not linear combination of this vector. So our topic is so linear span today. Okay, first of all, what is linear span? What is linear span? S is equal to v1 v2 vn be the non-empty subset of a vector space V over A. I'm taking that S is equal to v1 v2 vn be a non-empty subset of a vector space V over A. Please stop. The set of all possible linear combination of vectors of S is called linear span. It is denoted by L of S or span of V1, V2, Vn. Therefore, L of S written as span of V1, V2, Vn that equal to gamma, such that gamma is equal to summation of Ai, Vi. I is any value here. So, for all Ai belongs to F and Vi belonging to S. So, be careful here. I am writing what I am saying here. S is equal to V1, V2, Vn, minus subset of V over F. The set of all possible linear combination of vectors of S is called linear span. It is denoted by L of S or span of V1, V2, Vn. Therefore, L of S is equal to span of S that equal to gamma, such that gamma is equal to summation Ai, Vi. These are the set of all possible linear combination of vectors, right? So, I will explain how it is happened here. So, I am taking that S is equal to one set, right? Okay. S is equal to what I am taking here? S will be a non-empty set. So, I am taking that this is V1. Okay. So, V2. Vn. So, this is the subset of R equal to subset R equal to V. B an non-empty subset of V. Okay. What is the linear combination of I want to take that first of all my V over F is a vector space. Yeah, V over F is a vector space and S is non-empty subset of V. So if I take that A1, A2, right, so okay. A n belonging to F. I am taking this element belonging to F. Okay. So S is equal to V1, V2, Vn and subset equal to Vn, A1 belongs to F. What is linear combination? If I took that A1, this element is right. Okay. So A1 V1 plus A2 V2 plus dash 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 plus AN VN. So this is a linear combination vector. If I multiply after adding, we will get one vector. Thus vector we are calling, I am calling this vector is gamma. And this vector I am calling is gamma, right? So, let V over B vector space, S is equal to V1, V2, Vn, V subset equal to V, and A1, comma A2, comma data thin belongs to F. Then, this is called linear combination of vector. This may be written as, see, in the form of summation, how it written as, this is summation I equal to 1 to N. How can you write as this is AI, VI. So this is AI, VI. AI, VI. So this is a linear combination, one linear combination. My linear span is set up all possible linear combination of vectors F. It's called linear span. This is a linear combination, right? Set up all possible, that means so if I take a1, v1, v2, v2, v1 equal, we'll get one summation. This is gamma. One gamma will get. If I do other thing, okay. Suppose my a1, instead of a1, I may take a2 right here. a2 b1 plus a3 v2 plus, so what I'm doing, I'm shifting, I'm rotating. First a1 comes this side, a2, a3, it come like this. It is come to sides, okay. A1 goes to B1. Right, I am writing here, this is A1. A1 times of B1. If you write this equal to, so we will get another summation, right? We will get the summation, okay, some AI plus 1, or we'll get some other thing, right? This is summation AI VI. Will the other summation, I'm unable to write here. How would I write here? I plus 1, but up to, okay, I plus 1. I is equal to 1 to n minus 1. Okay, this term unable to write here. Plus, I'm writing this is a1 vn. So, this is the one term I'm writing this. Similarly, if I take that other thing, you can take that other way. So, that means so if I take a2 here, first to a2. A2 V1 plus A2 V1 not only A2 here, A3 V1. A3 V1 and A4 V2 plus dash. What I'm writing here? We'll get that summation. Here A1, A2, right? A2, BN. So next, what I'm doing here, you will get summation something else, right? If I do A4 here, shifting is right, we will get some possible combination of linear combination, right? Here gamma will change other element. This gamma may change. This also may change. If I get to adding this other element, you will get other value. Similarly, you can take that A4 first and similar A4 5. So later, what you do that just shift to this element, A2 V1, A1 V1. So rest of will put all same. Next you shift at A2 V3, you will get all same. That means there are possible infinite ways we can write like this. Okay, so that's why I am here unable to write here. So that means I will mention all these things. So by together, I want to write all same, right? This is one possible linear combination. This is one possible linear combination. This one possible linear combination. If I shift like this, we will get any linear combination. See what we will get here. A1 shift to A2. You can shift to only this. A1, A2, V1. A1 we will get. We will get another linear combination. If I shift to this, so A2, V1, A2, V3, remaining all the same, we will get another linear combination. Like that, if we will do all these things, we will get. Right, we will get different kind of linear combinations. So similarly, set up all linear combination. That means this one linear combination like it. So many ways we can write as the possible linear combination, the possible set of all linear combination. So that's why I am denoting that the possible linear combination of this set, right? So this is one summation I. So gamma such that gamma may be n equal to, right? Gamma equal to, you can write anything. So summation, that's why I'm not writing any I equal to here. Summation I AI VI, right? So this is the linear combination, right? This set is called set of all possible linear combination of S is called linear span. That equal to, I'm writing this is linear span, nothing but linear span. Okay, so I'm denoting this linear span, nothing but L of S. Linear span of here S my S is right, that's why I'm writing here L of span. Set over can that L of S, linear span, nothing but I'm writing this. Otherwise, instead of writing L of S, we may write this also. S contains V1, V2, Vn. That's why I'm writing here span up. Simply, I'm writing here. So, span up V1, V2, V3. Dash, dash, dash. Vn. So this is span up. Therefore, L of S is equal to this, and that equal to we may write as span up V1, V2, right? This is notation of linear span. If my vector changes, if it becomes U1, U2, U3, this becomes L of S equal to span of U1, U2, U3, right? Notation cannot be same. This notation will be changes according to the elements of vectors S. Then the elements of vector with changes, the span of V1 also changes, right? Here also it changes, summation gamma equal to AI, VI. Instead of VI, you will get here UI. So, this is the linear span. Okay. So, that means S is equal to V1, V2, V, and B non-empty subset of vector space V1F. The set of all possible linear combination of vectors of S is called linear span. It is denoted by L of S or span of V1, V2, dad as Vn. Therefore, L of S is equal to span of V1, V2, Vn. That equal to gamma, so there gamma summation AI, VI. For all AI belongs to F and VI belongs to F. We are, I am forget to write here. This AI is belonging to, already I am written AI is belongs to F and VI is belongs to S. So, VI belongs to S. Okay. Let S be a non-empty set of V or F, then L of S or span of S is a subspace of V over F. Or you can take that, let S is equal to V1, V2, Vn be the non-empty set of V over F, then L of S or span of V1, Vn is a linear subspace of, is a subspace of V over F. I'm taking that, let S be a non-empty set of V over F. L of S equal to span S, that equal to gamma, so that gamma equal to summation AI VI for all AI belongs to F and VI belonging to S. So this is according to definition I am writing here. S be an ancestor of URF, then L of S or span of S is the subspace of URF. That is one statement. Other thing is S is equal to V1, V2, Vn, be a linear non-ancestor of URF, then L of S or span of V1, Vn, that as Vn is subspace of F. Right? Here I am taking that S is equal to non-empty set, that's if S is equal to, if I take S is equal to V1, V2, dash Vn, alpha kilom L of S, that means L of S that will be equal to span of V1, Vn. So, if any element belonging to L of S, that means it is a linear combination of elements of S. If I take alpha belongs to L of S, which nothing but alpha is a linear combination of L of S. That's why I'm writing here alpha is equal to A1, V1, A2, V2 plus dash An, Vn. If I take beta belongs to L of S, so that means beta is also a linear combination of vectors of S, which implies beta is equal to B1, V1 plus B2, V2 plus dash Bn, Vn. So, this I am taking elements. What can I show? I want to show that span of this L of S linear subspace of U or F. For showing L of S subspace of U or F, what can I show that? I want to take that A comma B belongs to F. Alpha comma beta belongs to L of S. So, for showing L of S subspace of U or F, for this A alpha plus B beta belongs to L of S. I want to show this. So, I am considering here A alpha plus B beta. A alpha. A times of alpha nothing but my alpha is A1 B1 plus A2 B2 divided as AN BN. Plus B times of what is beta? B1 B1 plus B2 B2 divided as BN BN. This is my beta. If I multiply this thing, a times of a1 v1 plus a times of a2 v2 plus z as a times of an vn, according to the, since so, these are all belonging to L, v over f, the vectors of v over f satisfies all properties of vector space. Out of 10 properties of vector space, this is one of the property, that is distributive law property. That's why according using distributive law property, I am writing this. Okay. Here, same you can do b times of this thing, you can write here. Next, what I am doing here, a a1 e1, because one property is there, ninth property, c times of du is equal to v as cd v1. C times of du is equal to cd times of u. I am using this property, ninth property here. A times of a1 v1 is written as a a1 v1. Similarly, a times of a2 v written as a a2 v2. Therefore, similarly, a an vn written as a an vn. Right? So, plus b b1 v1 plus b b2 v2 plus that as b bn vn. So, this can be written as like this. So, therefore, V is vector space. Since V is a vector space, that's why I am writing by using vector space formula. Right? Here, what I am doing here? A1 plus B1. If I take common out, that means E1 take common out, we will get this. It is not simple. Why? Because since V is a vector space, it satisfies all properties. So, by using this, we can apply associate property. This is the bracket is there. Here also some bracket is there. By using associate property, we have to this use this associate, apply associate of this element to this. Next, apply associate property inbuilt. Then apply apply abelian property. So next apply abelian associate abelian. This come this here. Next to similarly, you can apply associative abelian property this thing. So, finally, we will get a1 v1 plus bb1 v1, a2 u2 and bb2 u2 like this. Again, apply vector space property, that means distributive law property, a1 u1 plus bb1 v1, take the u1 come out, that a1 plus bb1 v times, so that is so distributive law property. Similarly, apply all this property to all elements. So we will get this expression. So see, a1 b1 b1 belongs to, see, since f is vector space, a comma b comma a1 comma b1 belonging to f. So f is field, right? F is a field. This element belonging to a1 bb1 belongs to field. That's why a1 bb1 belongs to also field. So which implies this element also belong to field. This element also belong into field. So that means this is a my linear combination definition. What it says that if a1 comma a2 comma an belongs to f and v1 comma v2 belongs to that as vn belongs to s, so then the expression a1 v1 plus a2 v2 plus an vn is called linear combination of vectors of v1 v2 vn. Here my vectors are same in the form, but in place of a1 v, what we have here, a1 plus bb1, what means after adding multiplication we will get same one number. That number I am calling a1. Instead of a1, what we have here, this expression for this element belongs to f. That means this element is a linear, a alpha plus b beta is a linear combination of v1 v2 that as vn, which implies a alpha plus b beta belongs to l of s for all a comma belongs to f and alpha comma belongs to l of s. Therefore, l of s is a span of v1 v2 dot as vn is a subspace of v over vector space, or that means span is subspace of v over vector space. Okay, another theorem, let v1 comma v2 comma are vectors of vector space v over f, then span of v1 v2 is subspace of v over f. Okay, let v1 comma v2 are two vectors of vector space v over f, then the span of v1 v2 is subspace of v over f. Proof: let v over f be a vector space and v1 comma v2 comma are vectors of vector space v over f. So let us take a span of v1 v2. L of s is equal to what we know, the span of s, span of nothing but span of v1 v2. So that means gamma, first that gamma is called a1 v1 a2 v2 for all ai belongs to. That means so this is one vector. So you can write a2 v1 a1 v1 a1 v1 a1 v1 a2 v1 a2 v1 0 times of a1 v1 plus 0 times of v2 and a2 v2 like this. You can write any ways. This is a setup of possible in a combination of these vectors by using scalars. Okay, so I want to take that alpha comma belongs to span of v1 v2 and a comma belongs to f. So I am taking that alpha is equal to a1 v1 a2 v2 and beta is equal to a1 v1 v2 v2. Yesterday, previously I am taking that it is look like span of v1 v2 as vn. Here I am taking that only two elements. That's why it is easy. It is for proving that a alpha plus b beta, a times of alpha nothing but this a1 v1 plus a2 v2, b times of beta nothing but b1 v1 plus b2 v2. This thing I know. So a times of a1 v1 plus a times of a2 v2 plus b times of b1 v1 plus b times of b2 v2. So same apply vector for properties. Finally we will get all vector for property. Then only we will get this thing a1 v1 plus b1 b1 times v1 a1 a2 plus b b2 times v2. Since v is vector space, then only we can write all properties, apply all properties. That means so this is vector of this is element of f. This also element of f. That means so a alpha plus b beta is linear combination of vectors of v1 comma v2, which implies a alpha plus b beta belongs to span of v1 comma v2 for all a comma b belongs to f and alpha comma beta belong to span of v1 comma v2. Therefore span of v1 comma v2 is subspace of v over f. Theorem, other thing, v1 comma v2 comma data as vp or vectors of vector space v over f, then span of v1 comma v2 comma data as vp is subspace of v over f. So let v over f vector space just now already proved. Similarly, I will prove that this exam point of it is very important theorem for let v over f be vector space, span of v1 equal to v data as vp or vectors of v over space. L of s nothing but span of v1 v2 data as vp. That is gamma of summation a1 v1 a2 v2 as a v vp for all ai belongs to f and vi belongs to v. I am taking that alpha comma beta belongs to L of s, that belongs span of v1 v2 vp. If I take any belong any element in span, it will look like it is in the form of a1 v1 plus a2 v2 plus data as a p v v. If I take beta belongs to L of s, it is also span, it belongs to span. That's why I am writing here beta is equal to b1 v1 plus b2 v2 plus z as bp vp and let a comma b belongs to f. I am considering this element a alpha plus b beta, that equal to a times of this element, b times of this element. Again you can apply same property, a times of a1 v1 plus a times of a2 v2 plus a times of bp vp and v1s of this thing only. So apply all proper vector space property. So the ninth property can get a1 v1 a2 v2. So next apply abelian associate properties continuously, we will get that a1 later we will get apply distributive law property. So we will get a1 plus bv1 into v1 plus z as avp vp vp. That means this element belong to vector field f. Why? Because this r element belong to field. Field satisfies all properties of associative and addition properties, closure properties. A1 belongs to F and A1 belongs to F, B B1 belongs to F and B B1 belongs to F, which implies A1 plus B B1 also belongs to F. Why? Because F is field, this element belongs to F, this element belongs to F, and this all belongs to F. V V1 comma V2 comma as V belongs span of V1 V2 V B. Therefore, E alpha plus B beta is a linear combination of V1 comma V2 comma V P, which implies E alpha plus B beta belongs to L of S for all A comma belongs to F and alpha comma beta belongs to L of S. So, right, L of S equal to span of V1 comma V2 comma data as Vp is a subspace of V over F, right? So, this all three theorems just now I explained all are same. If you learn one, you can prove all these things anyway. So, that's why it is exam point of it is important, right? You can learn these theorems. Problem. Let write a vector a minus 3b, b minus a, b is as a linear combination of linear columns of combination of vectors, right? You can write anything, right? As a linear combination of columns of this, we want to write this vector as a linear combination of columns of So H, linear combination of columns of H. H is equal to 1 minus 1 1 minus 3 1 0 0. H is equal to this. So I am writing A minus 3 B, A B minus 3 A B, right? A minus 3 B, B minus 3. So that equal to, I am writing, rewriting this A minus 3 B and minus A plus B, A plus 0 and 0 plus B. From this, by using vector addition, so this written as A minus A minus A 0 plus 3 minus 3 B, B 0 B. So if I take A common out, according to matrix multiplication, you can write here. So A times of 1 minus 1 1 0 plus B times of minus 3 1 0 0. That means, so these two vectors are the vectors of H. So 1 0 0, right? Therefore, A minus 3 B, B minus A B is linear combination of H. That is 1 minus 1 1 0 minus 3 1 0 0 1. For what values of H will Y be the subspace of R3 spanned by V1, V2, V3 if V1 is equal to this, V2 equal to this, and V3 is equal to this, and Y is equal to this. For what values of H? For what values of H will be, so here H will be Y be in the subspace of R3 spanned by V1, V2, V3 if V1 equal to V2 equal to this. Let R3 over the vector space. V1 is equal to this. 1 minus 1 minus 2. V2 is equal to 5 minus 3 minus 7 minus 4 minus 7. V3 is equal to minus 3 1 0. And Y is equal to minus 4 3 H. Span of V1 V2 V3 is subspace of R3 over R. Let Y is equal to A1 V1 plus A2 V2 plus A3 V3 I am taking. Y nothing but minus 4 3 H. Here Y is equal to in right Y is equal to minus 4 3 H. So minus 4 3 H times A1 times of V1, A2 times of V3, A2 times of V3. If I do here minus 4 3 H, that is equal to, I am multiplying here, minus 4 3 H equal to A1 minus A1 2 A2 plus 5 A2 minus 4 A2 7A2 minus 3A3 plus A3 comma 0. If I add these things, right? If I add this thing, minus 4 3H, A minus A1 minus 2A1 plus 5A2 minus 4A2 7A2 plus minus 3A3 A3 0, we will get, if adding these things, we will get this expression. So minus 4 3H is equal to A1 plus 5A2 minus 3A2 minus A1 minus 4A2 plus A3 minus 2A1 minus 7A2 plus 0. If I substitute, if I equaling these elements or these columns, both are, we will get that A1 minus 5A2 minus A3 equal to minus 4, minus A1 minus 4A2 plus A3 equal to 3, and minus 2A1 minus A1 equal to H. If I solve these equations, right? If I solve these equations, so, right? We will get that H is equal to 5. Okay? What I'm doing here, what I did here, so I am adding 1 and 2. We will get this equation. I want to multiply to equation 2 by 2 and adding subtracting 2 by 3, we will get this equation. From this we will get A2 minus A2 A3 minus 1, A2 minus 2A3 equals 6 minus H. So by you next time, what I am doing here, I want to use first and three equation. I want to first and three equation, we will get this expression. So from three equation we are getting other three equations, right? This and this and this. We are here, we are getting that 3A2 minus 6A3 H minus 8 minus A2 plus 2A3 equal to 6 minus H. If I solve 4 and 5, you will get this expression, right? So I think that these both are same equation, right? A2 minus 2A2 equal to minus 6 minus H, and 3A2. If I take 3A common out, both expressions are same. If I take minus 3, that's why that equal to 0, and 8 H minus 3 H plus H minus 8, therefore H is equal to 5. If H is equal to 5, then Y is span of V1 comma V2 comma V3. That means it is that what I do here, I want to take this Y, the linear combination this, by solving this element we will get H value. If I take H is equal to 5, this is a linear combination of this vector. So this ends this problem, this proved the problem. Let H be the set of all vectors of the form minus 2t, 5t, 3t. Find the value of V. The find the vector V in R3 such that H is equal to span V. Why does this show that H is subspace of R3? Aim. So this is practical problem 1. This is practical problem 1. So let H be a set of all vectors of the form minus 2t, 3t, 5t, 3t. So find the vectors V in R3 such that H is equal to span V. Why does this show that H is subspace of R3? Aim. If H is a set of all vectors of the form minus 2t, 5t, 3t, then to find the vectors V in R3 such that H is equal to span V, and to explain why does H subspace of R3. Principles: linear combination, linear sum, linear span. So linear span theorem. Theorem are required for problem. Let R3 over R be vector space. H is the set of all vectors of the form this minus 2t, 5t, 3t, such that t belongs to R. H is the form. So this vector I am writing here minus 2t, 5t, 3t, put t times of minus 2, 3, 5. TV. Right? This belongs to span V. Therefore, V is equal to minus 2, 5, 3. So let H is equal to span V. That means H is equal to span V. H is equal to, we will get span V. So by principle of this, here by theorem, we get that span V is subspace of U over F. Span V is a subspace of U over F. By theorem, just now already proved that if V is vector of V1, then V is subspace of U over F. That's why here, V is vector of V, V1 comes to vector of V, then span of V1 V2 is vector space subspace of U over F. Similarly, if V is vector of V, and span V is subspace of V over F. That means H is plus span V. So span V is subspace of V over F. That is H is equal to span V, therefore H is subspace of V over F. So by using this principle, I am easily saying that why does this show that H is subspace of R3? That means H is span of V. That's why by using theorem, we can easily show that it is a subspace of R3. Result: if H is be a set of all vectors in the form minus 2t, 5t, 3t, then V is equal to minus 2, 5, 3 in R3, and V explain that why H is a subspace of R3. So that's how we explained by using theorem. I have explained. Let H be the set of all vectors of the form 3t, 0, minus 7t, then show that H is subspace of R3. Let H be the set of all vectors of the form 3t, 0, minus 7t, then show that H is subspace of R3. So again, whatever H is subspace of vectors is found, right? Therefore, H is equal to 3t, 0, 3, right? 2 plus 3. Consider one set 3t equal to 0, minus 7t, and take common out the 3, 0, minus 7t. So t times of V, that means it is a linear combination of vectors of V. Therefore, H is span V is subspace of R3. H is span V is a subspace of R3. Let again I am taking other problem. Let V be the set of all vectors of the form 2s plus 4t, 2s, 2s minus 3t, where s comma t, then show that W is subspace of R3. Let R3 over R is a vector space. W is equal to 2s plus 4t, 2s, 2s minus 4t, 3t. So is that s comma t belongs to R. Consider 2s plus 4t, 2s, 2s minus 3t, 5t. That is equal to what happened here? 2s, 2s, 2s plus 4t, 0, minus 3t, right? From here, I am taking common out s. So if I take s common out, then what will get here? 2, 2, 2, 0. If I take t common out from here, minus 4, 4, 0, minus 3, 5. That means it is s plus sv plus tv2. sv1 plus tv2. Therefore, is a linear combination of V1, V2. That means W is a span of V1, V2. Is a subspace of R3. Okay. W is span of V1, V2 is a subspace of R3. Okay. Let I take another problem. Let V1 is equal to 1, 0, minus 1, V2 is equal to 1, 3, V3 is equal to 4, 2, 6, W is equal to 3, 1, 2. Is W is in this set? is w belong to is in v1 v2 v3 and how many vectors are in v1 v2 v3 b okay this one problem is w in v1 v2 v3 question mark and how many vectors are there in v1 v2 v3 b how many vectors are in span of v1 v2 v3 c is w in the subspace of span by v1 v2 v3 question mark why let us take that v1 v2 v3 and w v1 equal to this and v2 equal to this a is equal to this w is equal to this a W is not in V1, V2, V3. Why? Because this element is not in the form like this, right? This is different from this. Therefore, W is not in V1, V1, V3. There are three vectors only in V1, V2, V3. How many vectors? It is only, it has only three vectors, V1, V2, V3. So, it has only three vectors. Span of V1, V2, okay? So, it has infinite vectors. That means A1, V1, A2, V2, A3 is equal to X, Y, Z. So, what the question is, how many vectors are there in span? Span has infinite vectors. Span has infinite vectors. Set of all possible linear combinations, that means it has infinite possible combinations, linear combinations, that's why span has infinite possible vectors, right? That means it has, so every LHP has infinite vectors. That means span has infinite vectors. W is the space of span of V1, V2, if I am lonely, for A1, V1, A2, V2, A3, V3, W has solution. W is subspace of U, span of V1, V2, V3. If I only A1, V1 plus A2, V2 plus A3, V3 is equal to W has a solution. Which implies A1 times of this plus A2 times of this, A3 times of this vector. And if I get, if I add this element, we will get A1 to A2 as this. Okay. What I am doing here now? I am adding these vectors. A1 plus 2A2 plus 4A3. This plus this. And this plus this plus this. That is equal to 3, 1, 2. Which equal to this. If I substitute this value, then what happens when A1 plus 2A2 plus 4A3 is equal to 3, A2 plus 2A2 is 1, minus A1 plus 3A2 equal to 6A2. If I solve this 1 plus 3, we will get 5A2 plus 10A3, 5, that is equal to A2 plus 2A2. If I do 2 minus 4, we will get that A1 equal to plus or minus 7. That means it has infinite many solutions. So one of the is A1 equal to 1, A2 equal to minus 1, A3 equal to 1. So, W is a subspace of span of V1, V2, V3. So, this in the lecture 10, lecture 6 by Dr. P. Ramlu. So, thank you for watching this lecture.